Happy children, successful children. However, these days, what has happened is that we have associated happiness with success. And success also means very often material success. Both are important. One cannot say that we don't want our children to be prosperous. They should be. But we should not equate the two as same. We have to teach our children how to be happy, and we have to also teach them how to be successful. If they are happy, they are successful, but if they are monetarily successful, it does not guarantee happiness. And you just show love, you can transform people. That's the greatest miracle that my guru Swami Chinmayananda taught me. The Upanishads, the Bhagavad Gita, they are not just giving us do's and don'ts. Even spiritual knowledge, they are not giving us do's and don'ts. They help us to develop our thinking faculty in such a manner that to whatever situation in life, whatever may be the problems and crises of life, once we have developed that faculty, we can apply that knowledge wherever. That is true education, that is true upbringing that we can give to our children. If each of you can at least study one Upanishad, even just the first and second chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, you will understand that how to develop not only these faculties within yourself, but also in your children. And that type of upbringing will go with them all their lives. I said, you asked for a car. You never said that you have to drive. He said, of course I want to drive. I said, why do you want to drive? He said, because I want to show off. I said, why do you want to show off? He said, because I want to enjoy the car. I said, why do you want to enjoy the car? He said, I want to be happy. I said, why do you want to be happy? Why does anybody want to be happy? And he had no more answer. See, we go to college to gain knowledge. Is knowledge for the sake of knowledge? No, it is to get a degree. Was a degree for the sake of degree? Who likes to just put a degree on the wall? Is to get a job. Is the job for the sake of job? It's for money. Is money for the sake of money? Be wise. If I want to be happy, find occasions to be happy. Don't find occasions to be miserable. Any life situation, you'll find two people in that situation. One is happy, one is miserable. That means the situation doesn't give you happiness or joy. It is the art of right contact with life. Lose your wealth, but never lose your mind. Lost wealth can be gained, but a lost mind is very hard to bring it back.